My name's Ian Ruhter. Some would say I'm an artist. I live in South Lake Tahoe, California. In this workshop we do video editing, and we work on the making the film, and we cut the plates and we varnish, and so everything has to be done, you know, by hand, and we do it all in this space. I grew up in South Lake Tahoe, and I went, you know, to school here, and I was raised in the mountains, and I started shooting snowboarding and all that, and that's kind of how I learned photography. And then I wanted to learn more, so I went to Los Angeles and started doing commercial photography and, you know, editorial stuff. And after a while, I just got really burnt out on that whole style of photography. It became more of like an application to make money, and all the art aspect of it got stripped away. So one day, I mean, I got this idea to do this project, and I just wanted to remove myself from that situation. And I had a little cabin up here in Tahoe still, so I just said, I'll just move up here. And I quit all my jobs, and I just, you know, the past 3 years, I've just been up here working on this. I think it was good for me to get out because, you know, Tahoe, it's a beautiful place, but it's also a really wild place. And a lot of the kids that I grew up with in school, you know, they're not around anymore. And I think if I would have stayed, you know, possibly that could have been my fate too. But now for me being back, you know, there's a lot of emotions in that. And brings back a lot of memories, and I miss a lot of people, but I remember a lot of good things. I did the snowboarding, you know, and I didn't take it very serious. And then that, you know, was short-lived, but I figured out, oh, I can make these pictures of my friends and maybe sell those. And when I got that chance, I took that very serious. And maybe I needed to fail at that first attempt at it. And then when I went into photography, it taught me a lesson to really take it serious and know that you have a good opportunity to do something. And so I cherish that, and I just put my whole heart into it. I remember when I stopped snowboarding, I didn't have any income at all. And I was like, well, I need to get a job. And I got a job being a barback at a bar. And I remember seeing all my friends coming in, and they're still partying. And I'm sitting there just cleaning up trash and working. It was real humbling experience. I remember when I was bartending, and there's all these cocktail waitresses because it's in a casino, and they're just old and crusty. And I'd tell them, I'm gonna shoot photos, I'm saving money to get a camera, that's what I'm gonna do. And they're like, yeah, good luck. And the day I quit, I remember this one lady, she said, yeah, you'll be back, no one ever leaves here. And gosh, it's been 20 years. I go back in there and she's still working in there. It didn't just start off that I was gonna have a camera truck. I started making these plates, but they're 8x10 inch size, and that's about a normal size, you know? And the idea was that I wanted to have original pieces that were at the size that I wanted. I'm not making enlargements. So I had to come up with this idea of how I was gonna get a huge camera. And I'm like, oh, a truck, it's a big box. I can move it around. And then this whole idea just took over my life as soon as I started. Like, once I got that in my head, I couldn't let it go, and I just kept, like, it changed my whole life from one single idea. I really wanna travel through America with this truck and this process. I think America's really interesting to me, and I don't think anyone's really touched on it, like really touched on it in the past 20 years. And I don't know, there's every country and every culture lives here. And even in one city, you could potentially see the whole world because it's such a melting pot of people. And I think, you know, you spread that out to the South and the North and the East and the West, just those amount of stories and places. Those are the ones I'm really interested in telling those stories. I'd like for my work to end up in museums because I look at the old pictures of like Billy the Kid and Abraham Lincoln and that, and this is the same process. So there's that historical value to it, but also, you know, showing what America is and not just the sides that people know about. I mean, we still have like KKK in America, we have a black president, we have so many things going on. I mean, that's just the scratching the surface, and you go into all these like subcultures throughout, and those are the stories and the people that I really want to tell through this process. When we started with the truck, I had some inquiries to buy pieces and everything, but I didn't want to sell them because I didn't even know what I had. I didn't even have a body of work, and to start whittling things away before, you know, I built a piece was not right for me. I'm really excited about show I'm having at the Fahey Klein Gallery in October. I've never shown the original works publicly, and this will be the first one, so it's like, you know, 3 years of work or my whole life's work bundled up in this one thing, and this will be the first one, so it'll be one to remember. Thanks for checking out DKS, and we'll see you next time.